following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Dave in Clearwater. Hey, Dave, Happy New Year. What's happening, man?
Happy New Year to you, my brother. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
I am doing well, man. I'm doing well. Can I throw a quote out at you?
Sure.
In the market, somebody knows something. Someone always knows something. That statement was made by a great trader by the name of Tom O'Brien about 6-7 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And it kind of hit me like a brick. You're right. Somebody always knows something.
Hey, Carlos, what's going on, brother?
I'm calling you back, Tom. This morning, I had a pleasure to talk to you and your son, and I don't want to miss the opportunity to talk to you again.
Well, I think you made some money on this bond.
Oh, yes, Tom. Your newsletter helped me.
That's a beautiful thing. We appreciate the growling problem with us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Release the need to be right. When you believe something, you assume you're right. You may even destroy relationships in order to defend the opposition. Let go of the need to defend your position. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 142, NASDAQ up 48, S&P's up 17, gold contract down $12.60, trading at $11.98.30. Silver down 21 cents, $16.97 an ounce. Platinum down $14 at $9.81 an ounce. Copper flat, $2.70 a pound. Light sweet crude down 37 cents, trading at $52.80 a barrel. Yeah, the oil numbers come out this morning. Lots of oil around. Bottom line, you went down slightly. Then you took off upside like 70 cents. Then it just couldn't hold price. Oil, folks, is in the lower range. Oil looks like it's going to start making a run back for the $50 area. We'll see whether we break down at that area. That area is where OPEC met. That's the highs of the November meeting. Notes, 10-year note down 12 ticks, 123.26. 30-year bond off a full point plus 4 ticks, 149.15. Now, both notes and bonds, they go topside 2 days ago, have volume. Go downtown yesterday with light volume. Downtown today, they're breaking the swing point from Monday with lighter volume. We'll see whether they reject price. Bottom line, that is still saying that notes and bonds want higher price, but you need a rejection of price. King dollar. King dollar down 289 ticks, traded at 100.050. King dollar can't hold price. We've been down for about 3 weeks right now. It tested the highs 3 separate times, couldn't handle it. Comes off the highs with volume. Last few days, you get light volume. Bottom line, there's sellers in King Dollar and there's no buyers. King Dollar looks like it's going to go down I suspect the 95 area. The first next test is going to be at the 98 area. That area is from the November swing low. The euro. Euro is trading at 107 and the yen is at 113.65. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wonder what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You get the SPY. We're trading 46 million shares. Yesterday, we do 95 million. Bottom line, you're at a higher high. You don't have volume. You don't have people buying it. But guess what? There's enough buying it to keep it up at a high. So we'll see how much they can basically bring this up. Your swing point that you're taking out is the swing that was the last high. Last high up here was established on December 13th. That was 228.34. You had 110 million shares. Right now, you're at 46 million. Dow Industrials hit the 20,000. We're actually 50 points over the 20,000 right now. 20,058. That's where we're at. We've hit 20,082 out here today. When we take a look at the volume inside the index itself, volume out here is at 554. So we will not do, doesn't look like we're going to do 800 million. The composite, NASDAQ composite, that continues to keep hitting highs. Composite gaps higher out here today. We hit 56.54, and we're kind of laying right at these highs. We're at 56.49 right now. NDX 100 also much higher. Bottom line, no volume. But bottom line, you're at a higher price. You know, so the extension's pretty amazing. You go back to December 30th, you're at 118. We're at 125. You've done 11 million shares out here today. When we broke the first high going back to January 6th, we did 24 million, and that was light volume, folks. So you can see you're contracting in a dramatic way, but guess what? You're at a higher price. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract straight at 1198. You've done 284,000 contracts. You hit a low today of 1192. This 1198 area is important, and this is why. January 11th, you had a nice sign of strength. You went from a price point of 1177 to 1198.50. We did 329,000 contracts. So that is testing that area out here today. Now, we certainly, there's two different things that have happened here. You didn't get to the low of that bar, which is positive or bullish. We've rejected the 1198.50 a few times today. You know, we'll see whether it can come into the close and close above that area. If you close above that area, that's going to be a rejection on lower price with lighter volume. That'll say, once again, good old gold contract is going to start moving higher. And this does not negate the ABC structures that gold is in. You know, gold has two separate ABC structures, one inside the other, which is really powerful. Silver, same type of setup in silver. Silver has 60,000 contracts out here today. We hit a low of $16.78. A close in silver above $16.90 is going to be a rejection of price and volume. It looks like we're going to get it. That was 82,000 contracts we did on the 11th of December, of January rather. Right now you're at 60,000 contracts, and right now we're 7 cents over that level. Notes. We go to the note market. We take a look at notes. What you're going to see in the notes first is this. Number one, you get down to 123.23. We've done 1.2 million contracts. You broke the swing point of the 20th, which had 1.4 million contracts. You're going into the swing from the 3rd, which is 1.4 million contracts. If we get a close out here today, you know, where we are right now, that is saying that you, let's see, 123.25. Yeah, you're above 123.25. What I'd really like to see as we come into the close is a close above 124.03. Wouldn't take much. That would say, well, it takes six ticks. Right now you're at 123.27. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? King Dollar, folks, it's pretty amazing. King Dollar just can't catch a bid. You know, bottom line is that you're laying here with 26,000 contracts. King Dollar wants to get into 99.250. We'll see how we do it. We'll see that it, King Dollar just may jump the creek, meaning an open dramatically lower. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow's up 150.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency-hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go inside the Dow Industrial, see the strength versus the weakness. Inside the Dow out here, you have the strength is Boeing. That's up 4.3% or $7. You get Caterpillar up 1.8% or $1.76. Apple is up 1.6% or $1.95. J.P. Morgan is up up 1% or $1.05. The J.P. Morgan deal is pretty intense, folks. And what you have there is this State Street, which is the one of the largest back offices on Wall Street. They have a back office with $23 trillion, yes, with a T, $23 trillion dollars. BlackRock has just decided to move $1 trillion of their dollars, yes, a trillion, from State Street to J.P. Morgan. So it's a big move. State Street, that's STT, the symbol. That out here is trading down right now, 285, which isn't bad, by the way, for losing $1 trillion under management. Let's see if we pull this back a bit. So this has been, it's not going to make it over its high. So if you want to see something, the high in 2008 was 86. You had volume up there. 132 million on the monthly. You come up and tested it with 40 million, and then we tested it with 42 million. And what you're going to be doing, you're going to be coming off that high with big volume. This will make its way. This will probably make its way down to somewhere. Well, the first leg would be 63. Big number though, man. That was no doubt a big number, big loss. Because the real question is going to be, is that what other firms stop moving around and what was the deal? Meaning it's going to be probably a very small increment percentage-wise of what they're saving, but on $1 trillion, you can imagine that turns into big money. Inside the Dow, the laggards out here today was American Express. That was down 0.8%. United Technologies off 0.7%. Procter & Gamble down 0.7%. Inside the NDX 100, the leader out here, Seagate Technology, that's up 15% or $5.66. Western Digital, up 5%. That they're two hard drive makers. You had Intuitive Surgical up 4.5% and Qualcomm up 3.2%. Taken away from it on the way down, you had CA is down 4.9%. Discovery Communications is off 2.8%. Vodafone is down 2.5%. and Express Scripts is down 2.4. We take a look at the small caps. Now, for the Dow getting the, well, here, let's look at the percentages first, because percentage-wise, what we have is this, is that you have the Dow Industrials up 0.6%, S&Ps are up 0.7%, NASDAQ is up 0.8%. We go over to the small cap arena, what you're going to see is this. The IWM looks like it's going to fail on price and volume. We hit the IWM today, the small caps hit $137.55. You're going into the downdraft from the 14th of December, 137.35 is the number. And it looks like we're going to close underneath that. The volume characteristic from that is 45 million. Right now, you're at 20 million. So, you know, we'll see where this shakes out in the small cap area, but it looks like that indice, no doubt, wants to fail on price and volume. After the close out here today at 4, you get a lot of equities coming out with numbers. We're going to, from this point on, the next 5, 6, 7 days, excluding Friday, you're going to have some big numbers coming out. Some of the higher volume stocks out here today, AK Steel is down 43 cents. You get Advanced Micro down 14 cents. Freeport MacMoran is down 63. Bank of America is up 37. You get Apple up $1.90. Qualcomm, that's a counter trend bounce that got smoked last few days. That's down, that's up $1.70. Let's go take a look at U.S. Steel. U.S. Steel is down $1.24. What's intriguing about the steel companies, of course, folks, is that you had this. The run was extraordinary. The run started on November 2nd. That run started at $17, moves all the way up to $39. Bottom line is that they are going to open up those pipelines and they're going to need a lot of steel. But guess what? There's the perfect situation that the run had already taken place. The equities had already got the charge. They announced that they're going to have a shot to need a lot more steel. And guess what? They sell the babies down. Let's go over and take a look at the XAU and the HUI. So inside the gold equities out here today, XAU went to a price point of $89.10. Rejected lower price. Right now you're at 90.35. We take a look at this, and what you're going to see is that what we did yesterday, and this is really intense if you happen to be in this market, is that you pushed into swings with volume. In fact, this is a beauty, man. So what the XAU has done is that now you get a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. And you talk about deviant. It's about as deviant as you can get, man. That, you know, you push with volume, you break a B point with volume, you pull back with lighter volume today, and this is a beauty, man. This is a big ABC too, man. So if we go, let's take a look. You get 73.89. I'm just going to ballpark at 73 to 90. You know, you're talking, let's say 74, 16 bucks. 86, 96, 102. And that lays out, man. That lays out for the swing points that are there from September. That's where this baby's going. 101 to 102 in the XAU. Gold Bugs Index. Let's go look at the Gold Bugs Index. Gold Bugs Index right now is trading at 204.89. Let's see. So we had 28 million. Okay, so the Gold Bugs Index didn't break the B point with volume. Bottom line, that at least gives you a test of the high of yesterday. Didn't break it with volume, pulled back today with lighter volume. Right now we're trading at 204.91. It'll be really interesting to see whether it can get to the 205.39 level as we come into this close. That level there, folks, would be the highs of the burst when we went higher on January 5th. That's where that level is laying out there. 877-927-6648. Right now we get the Dow Industrials up 143, NASDAQ is up 48, S&Ps are up 45. We go take a look at some of the Dow stocks out here. So you get ExxonMobil up 20 cents. In fact, let's go see how many are actually negative. There's not going to be many. So if we go into the Dow Industrials, you have, actually there is. That's interesting, man. I mean, for the Dow, as much as it's up, you got two, 2, 4, 6, 7. We got 7 negatives inside the Dow. And of course, that's the Dow 30. If we go into the NDX 100, we take a look at the NDX 100. Now, the thing that's pretty wild about the NDX 100, folks, is that there's actually 127 stocks inside the NDX 100. It started out as 100 stocks, but bottom line is 127 of them right now. So let's see what we have here if I bring all these up. Okay, so you have, out of the 127, this is pretty intense. Okay, so where is it? It starts right there. 97. It looks like you get, you know, you have 30. Yeah, you get 30 in the negative out of the 127. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Be right back, folks.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 149. Nasdaq's up 50. S&P's are up 18. Let's go to Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, Jim, what's going on?
Hey, how are you today?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Doing pretty good. It's pretty here.
Oh, man, it's beautiful, folks. There's no doubt, man. This day today is, like, incredible. It's like 73, 74 degrees. It's always beautiful, but this is, like, insane. I know. Love it.
Yeah. I wanted to ask you about BK, Bank of New York Mellon. Symbol BK.
What?
I was looking at maybe if it got down to 43, that would be a good support area to buy it, go long on it, but I don't think it's going to go down that low with all the rallying going on.
Let's take a look. So you get the BK, it's Bank of New York Mellon. The low is $32, the high is $45. They pay a 1.69% dividend. Oh, yeah, no, this little stock's in trouble, man. Just let this be. This thing's going to get all the way down to $40, okay? So watch this, folks, okay? Had the rally with the rest of the banks. This is interesting. This started rallying earlier. This started rallying. All the banks started rallying November 4th. This started October 19th. And then it goes from a price point of 39 all the way up to 49. Then it comes off that high with vicious volume. You see how we come up with volume, Jim? That's setting an ABC down up. You know, we come off the high. Well, first off, you got a high going with 6 million shares. You come off the high with 8 million, then 12 million, and then 13 million. You're doing a counter trend bounce today with 5, so your probability is that this is the B to a C of an ABC structure down, man. I wouldn't just let this looks to me, yeah, and it's also a false break. One second, hold on. Okay, so what this also did, I just brought this back, folks, a couple of years and put it on a weekly. That's a false break topside, man. This is really intriguing now. Okay. Boy, the yin and yang is on this one because the break itself did really well, meaning the volume was great on that break. Oh, but look at this. And this one, as soon as I bring it back in a monthly, don't forget it. No, this thing, yeah, you're going to have plenty of chance to buy this, man. I first off, let it go all the way down. It looks like it's an ABC down, so your A point would be 49. You get about $5.50. Yeah, the $40 area. This will probably fill up that whole gap where it started, folks, and Jim, at October 19th, man.
Okay. Well, that sounded good. I'm glad I called you.
Well, we'll see if it gets down there, man. But it looks like it's monster. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
You too.
Thanks. Yeah. Let's go to Max in Fort Lauderdale. Hey, Max, what's going on?
Hey, Happy New Year, Tom.
Happy New Year to you too, man. Let's make it a great one.
Yes. I'm looking at the GDX, and listening to your going over the yes. HUI and the XAU. The GDX just doesn't go with the volume. I don't see it breaking. The swing point seems to be on 1.5, and the volume at any bar over that is less volume.
That's correct. That's correct.
It looks worse on it weekly.
Let's go over it on a daily first, because I want to show you something. So if you have my book, folks, The Art of Time in the Trade, it's all about price and volume. So you got to remember something. You can't go up with volume forever, and you can't go down with volume forever. It just doesn't work. The theory is that it's a supply and demand equation as to where people are buying or selling. So the GDX, as Max is just saying, okay, we started off December 15th, it's at $18.60. It goes straight up, and on January 5th, it's at $23.35. Now it's there with some great volume, 135 million shares. Do you see how we going back underneath that level on the 11th? Of January, so you get to 21.90, okay? You go back topside again, it tries to take it out, and you get volume of 94 million. So you take it out in price, but yet it doesn't have the volume. So you get 94 million versus the 135, okay? Now, this is the crucial part to wrap your head around. When that happens, and then you get back under that swing point, which we did on the 19th, that first swing point, it's not negated, but that is not the swing point you're benchmarking. You're benchmarking the second swing point because it's showing that you went back, it failed, went back underneath it again. It's going to try it again. Next time we tried it, we did take out the swing with volume. We did 87 million. Oh, no, we still didn't. We did 87 million versus 94 million. Then yesterday, you get up and you did 78 million and you still haven't taken it out. You know, so it's going to try it again. What I do is this. So you're absolutely right in that correlation. Now let's go to the weekly. and you put the weekly on it, and on the weekly, what you're going to see is that we're coming into the downdraft with 636 million, and you only did 285. So that needs a lot more volume to get by that whole area. What? And I trade the nugget and the dust all the time. I mean, every single day, okay? And the nugget and the dust, folks, trade off of the GDX. Now, what I do, Max, is this. I look at the GDX, and I'm well aware that, you know, that's been happening. But what I also do is I go to the two largest weighting structures inside the GDX, which happens to be Barrick Gold is the largest weighting. Barrick took out a B point yesterday. It's a big ABC up. Took it out with volume. Ate it actually. 28 million shares versus 26. You go to Newmont. What happened this morning is that Newmont is one of the reasons that the GDX couldn't hold price yesterday. Newmont gave it up and gave it up quick. Newmont this morning basically has rejected the lows out here of 34.47. It looks like we're going to close over 34.79. Now, 34.79, folks, was the high of the 11th. So the two largest weighting structures inside the GDX right now look to me like they want to move higher. So if you trade the GDX, go through those 10 highest weighting structures, you know, and you're going to get a better understanding of where that GDX does want to go.
Yeah, the ABX looks real good today. Actually, I sold it yesterday. I might want to get back into it today, huh?
Yes. Yeah, well, let's do the numbers on it. So this is the reason I'm saying yes is that it's a confirmed ABC up. So the most conservative way to do this is that would say the A point's 1380, the B 1750. So you get almost $4, which would give you $20. It's $20.60. It's not bad. Yep. Do you know what I mean? Where you don't have to give it any juice, man. Don't, you know, put the stop right under the low of today.
Okay. Hey, thank you, Tom.
Did you sign up for my workshop tomorrow night?
I will. I'll be there.
Cool. Okay.
Okay.
Check it out. And folks, if you do, as we come over to our website at TFNN, I'm going to be doing a workshop tomorrow night. This is a free workshop. And folks, if you trade the nugget, the dust, if you trade gold, please come to the workshop. You're going to get a lot out of it, man. I'm having so much fun putting this workshop together. I'll talk about it as soon as we come back. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials right now up 150. Nasdaq's up 52. S&P's are up 18. We're going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering four-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, you're going to see right on the front, live event with myself, free to sign up. It's a lesson in trading, nugget and dust. It's going to be tomorrow night. The 26th, 6 to 7 Eastern Standard Time. All we need is your name and your email. And we do not sell emails, names, all of the above. What we're going to be talking about is this. If you trade any of the leverage products, you want to be in the workshop. If you trade the metals, you want to be in the workshop, okay? What we're going to talk about is this. The first section is going to be on the composition and the mechanics of leveraged ETFs, okay, how they work. Then we're going to get into what daily rebalancing actually means. You know what? We have white papers up on the site. I know many people have read them. Plenty of people haven't read them. That's going to help you tremendously to understand of what is getting rebalanced. What is the nugget and dug? What do they trade off of? So you can understand how they get rebalanced. Then we're going to talk about compounding. Compounding is the most important aspect. Well, knowing, understanding what they get rebalanced off is important. The compound's important, this is why. And any of you folks that have traded leveraged ETFs, you know that this has happened, you just don't know, some of you may not know why. Many of you may also know why, I'm not sure, but we'll find out when you get in this workshop. So when you have a leveraged ETF, and we're talking about the nugget in the dust, those are 300 bull or bear positions. If you get a market that rises steadily, let's say for 4 or 5 days, well, at the end of 4 or 5 days, you're actually going to be, if it goes the same way, just going up, you're actually going to be up more than 300%. I'm going to show you how that works. When a market steadily declines, I'm going to show you that you're actually down less than 300% on the way down, okay? Because these are daily investment vehicles. So when you get the composition and the mechanics and you see how they work, it's very clear. It gets really clear. It's really cool. I've been having a blast, as I said earlier, doing this PowerPoint, really getting it, making it as simple as possible. Then what you have is this. Then you have a market that's flat but volatile. Markets that are flat or volatile, guess what? The bull and the bear lose, and you'll see why. So that part there, the whole workshop's only going to take an hour. That part there, you'll see exactly what you're dealing with, and then you can make the choices. That the cool thing here is then you can make the choices. If you think the market's going to trend for 3 or 4 days, you make the choice. If you think the market's going to go down for 3 to 4 days, you make the choice. Then we're going to be talking about what I like to see when I'm trading the dust of the nugget. Where's the dollar going? Why do I think that? What's the speculation? And then, as we were just talking, when we were just talking to Max in Fort Lauderdale, the gold market, folks, is very small. You can bisect and dissect that pretty good. These trade off the GDX, but that being said, guess what? You want those weighting structures, you want to know where those weighting structures are each and every day, which is very easy to do. And then what you want to do is you want to look and say, okay, just like today, well, the ABX is in a confirmed ABC up. This is the largest weighting structure there is inside the GDX, inside the XAU. Bottom line, that makes a difference. Now, what we also know, and here's the yin and the yang of this, Newmont is not bad. That's the second largest weighting structure. But man, you know, they can just keep banging this thing down. If Newmont takes off, man, and you had ABX taken off, guess what? That right there is 18% of the GDX. Let's see exactly what it is as we're talking right now. So right now, and this updates intraday. So it's actually more than that. So Barrick Gold today is 10.79%, and Newmont's 9.76%. And see, the way that these get established also has to do with the pricing structure and the capitalization of the equities. And that's why you see Barrick much higher today. Yesterday that was 9.9%. It's 10.7 today because Barrick got a lift yesterday where Newmont didn't. Okay, so bottom line, we're going to talk about that. We're going to get you a clear understanding of it. Just come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go right in the front. You can sign up right now. Just a name and your email. After the close out here today, at 4:15, we get eBay coming out with numbers. eBay closed out here. eBay, my den's down. eBay is trading at $30.24. eBay right now, mine didn't come back up. Sorry. I can re-sign in when the commercial comes. eBay is trading at $30.28, and it looks to me, it would have been sweet if this comes out before 4:15, but it doesn't. So the first futures close at 4:15. eBay looks like it's going to give it up. Not heavily, but 28.75 looks like it's game on eBay. We go take a look at the dollar, which is pretty wild out here. So as we started the program out here, folks, the DXH7. The dollar index just croaked under 100. Now this is gonna be a big number because as we come into the close, it looks to me like the dollar's trading 99.940. It looks like that we can get to 99.900. And if we do that, I can make a case 101. Yeah, it's a beauty. 101 what? Let's see. It's a monster ABC down. 101.485. That's almost 1,500 ticks. So that would bring you to 99.350, 98.750. That's where, and let's see where that swing point is. 99.250. So check this out. This ABC structure down is an intraday ABC structure happening right now from the last 4 days. That is actually saying that it's going to break the 99.250, which is 700 ticks down from where we are. So we very well could be at 98.980 tomorrow morning. There's going to be some action out here tonight. That's how the dollar index is set up right now. If we go over to the euro, we take a look at this euro. Euro looks like it's set to, you know, go after 108. And right now you're at 107.45. We'll see what's going to make that make those babies move. So let's go after the yen, because if that's going to happen, that's saying that the yen is also going to get stronger. The yen right now is trading at 113.36. We'll see whether it makes a run down to the 112.61. Yeah, that'd be pretty easy to do. You know, we don't have volume in the yen right now. In fact, I got to put the yen futures up so I can get the volume. But you get two separate downdrafts. We get a downdraft that took place at 7 o'clock this morning, as well as right when I started the program at 3 o'clock. Pretty good downdrafts, too. You know, so that's saying the yen does want to get down to the 113.23 area. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow up 163. NASDAQ up 56. S&Ps are up by 20. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns, as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is up 165. You get the Nasdaq up 57. S&Ps are up 20. Percentage-wise, this is what you have out here. You have the Dow up by 0.8%. Nasdaq up is up 0.1%. S&Ps are up 0.7%. And after the close out here, we're going to have big numbers all over the place. Lots of earnings that will be coming out. We'll see what that can do inside the marketplace. Dollar index continues to get pressure. You know, we'll see where this shakes out overnight. But what you have out here, the low in the dollar was established out here this morning at 7 o'clock. Bottom line, it's going right after this low. Right now we're at 99.930. And what's intriguing here is that the last 2 days, that's what we've kind of had. You get a push down yesterday coming into the close, and we'll get another one now. But you can make the case the dollar doesn't have to be down much lower, 99.885, you know, to basically be breaking a consolidation that it's been in of an ABC structure on the way down for the last 2 days. You know, the volume's all downtown. You know, bottom line, your peaks are lower, your volume characteristics is lower, and you know, we'll see where this does shake out. You know, after the bell out here, you're gonna have eBay, PayPal, Qualcomm. Let's see, I think Qualcomm that also comes out at 4:30. None of these guys are gonna help me to come up. This is gonna be interesting though. No, Qualcomm. Okay, so Qualcomm just says after the market. So Qualcomm may come out when the futures are still open. And, you know, Qualcomm, that came down hard, 94 million shares. And what that's all about, of course, the government was going after Qualcomm. Apple's going after Qualcomm. It's a pile-on situation. And as that did break down, that has a high volume swing low. So you get a decent probability that it's going to go test that high volume swing low. eBay's coming out at 415. That's 415. Let's go PYPL, PayPal. Is coming out. Okay, so PayPal will get some juice. I don't believe that's in the Index 100, but that has some juice. And what PayPal also has, though, PayPal wants to go higher. PayPal's at 41.76. This looks like it wants to get up into the 44.24 level. LVS Las Vegas Sands, that just says after the market. He comes out pretty late most of the time. Las Vegas Sands wants lower price. You're up at 56. It looks to me like this wants to get down to 54. And if we put this, that has some heavy selling pressure. Mabel, that's United Rentals, URI. Let's see. This is trading 114.79. Yeah, this thing wants higher price. Between this is a rental company, folks, that all those signs that you see on all the roads getting built, that's what this is all about. Housing, latrines, all of the above. And bottom line is that I suspect that their analysis going forward is going to be pretty dramatic, saying that they expect big business if, in fact, these infrastructures are going to get built. Ma Bell's also coming out with numbers. That's going to be right after the market. Ma Bell's trading at 41.42. And this here, let's see. So we're at 41.42. Yeah, this can go tap the 43.55 area. Volume that we have out here, NYSE, you're at 672. That means it's 772 probably at the most. You get 3 or 4 minutes to get it in. NASDAQ will probably do about 1.2. I can do 2 billion. 87. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back. We'll be coming back with lots of numbers. Dow up 163. NASDAQ up 55. S&P's up 20. We're going to be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following is a presentation of TFNN.
The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Marty in Worcester. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hi, Mr. O'Brien. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you been, man?
Not bad.
Good.
In fact, you know, you guys, over the time and with a few of your courses and seminars, you know, you taught me how to fish.
That's a beautiful thing, brother. That's so cool.
Right, yeah, it's true. And so what happens is I still listen all the time, and to not only you, but some of the others.
Sure.
To, you know, get an idea where the fish might be biting.
Yeah.
but as far as your services, they're a bargain. When you compare them to a certain prominent man with real estate courses at $35,000 and no contact with the lecturers afterwards at all, and you think of what you guys do for a few hundred, and you can get access and ask questions forever, you know, it's a great deal.
No, we appreciate the growling problem with us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Well, folks, this is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Love is unconditional. In love, there are no conditions. You love for no reason with no justification. You are free to be who you are, and you allow others to be what they are. And the fish were biting out here today, folks. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials up 155, NASDAQ up 55, S&P's up 19, gold contract down $11.20, trading at $11.99.60 an ounce. Silver down 18 cents at $17 an ounce. Platinum down $14 at $9.81 an ounce. Copper flat, $2.71 a pound. Light sweet crude down 35 cents, $52.83 a barrel. Oil numbers came out today, folks. Bottom line, we had a buildup in oil. When the numbers come out, oil shot down 20, 30 cents, then went up 70 and then gave it up. Oil wants to trade back into this $50 level. We'll see how it handles that November high. Bonds, the 10-year note, down 11 ticks, 123.27. 30-year bond off a full point, plus two ticks, 149.17. Now, both notes and bonds, folks, broke a lower swing point, broke them with light volume, but they didn't reject price. King dollar down 449 ticks at 99.885. King dollar has a big problem here. We've tested the highs three separate times. That was a few weeks ago. You came off the high with volume. Last couple days, we had light volume. You had an expansion slightly today, but someone's hammering King dollar, folks. I expect you're going to see King dollar down to 98, probably down another 1,000 ticks overnight. This thing's getting a little hammering, and there's not much in the way from where we are right now at the 99.890 to the 98.890. The euro is trading at 107, and the yen is at 113.26. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wonder what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? SPY's done 75 million shares. You're closing at the high of the day. You're at 229.57. Bottom line, that is the high of the day. Took out the swing point, light volume, but guess what? Higher highs, you can go higher. Dow Industrials. What do we do with the Dow Industrials? Dow Industrials traded up on 155. You're at 20,068. Same type of setup. If we take a look at the indice volume out here, what you have is that we've done 879 million, which is that's a lot of volume at the close, no doubt about that. We'll see where it shakes out. NASDAQ Composite. We go to the NASDAQ Composite. What do you have with the composite? Composite gapped higher this morning. You're at 56.56. And the composite volume we did 1.9 billion. So still not doing 2 billion, but not that bad. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract, folks, rejected, lower price, had lighter volume. We are at, first off, the gold contract got down to 11.9260. It did 289,000 contracts. It was going into 329,000 contracts. The high of that day, which was the 11th of January, was 11.9850. We're 1,210. Bottom line, you come down, you hit that bar, you have lighter volume, rejected it, you go higher. Gold is already in an ABC structure. Actually, it's in two separate ABC structures, and that's very powerful in itself. Bottom line, gold wants higher price. I suspect we're going to be up at this 1251 area. Silver, same setup in silver. And both gold and silver, folks, there's no doubt they've been deviant. It's a beautiful thing. And the more deviant they get, the better off it is. And what I mean specifically by that is that when it's hard to buy them, when the whole world thinks it's going south, bottom line, that's when it goes north. Silver contract goes down to $16.78. You did 61,000 contracts. You were coming into 82,000 contracts. That day was the 11th of January. The high of that day is $16.90. We are at $17. So same type of setup in the silver contract. You're building cars, and we're building cars right there for higher price. The notes, let's go to the note market next. We take a look at the note market, 10-year note. 10-year note out here traded down to 123.23. You did 1.3 million contracts. Now that's light contract volume, but couldn't hold price. So, you know, you broke the swing point going back to the 19th and the 20th. We had 1.4 million on the 20th. You had 1.8 million on the 19th. And you're still coming into 1.442, which at 123.18. So we'll see whether it's going to tag that baby tomorrow. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? King Dollar, folks, okay, is good. It's going to be pretty wild watching this shake out tonight. The reason being is that as we finished up the 4 o'clock hour, what you had is that you had a good old King Dollar coming into the swing low of 99.920. It broke it. Next stop is 99.250. That being said, the way that it is actually set up, though, intraday, is that it looks like it's a much larger ABC structure. You know, once you're under the 99.900, which are at 99.905, that sets up not only the test of the low of December 8th, I suspect it sets up a run down to 98.720. So, bottom line, what I expect you're going to see out here tonight, that you're going to see big action inside that currency market. Qualcomm come out with numbers. Qualcomm closed at 56.90. That's trading at 56.25. Las Vegas Sands, LVS, that come out with numbers. That's traded at 56. Closed at 56.65. That's trading at 54.28. As soon as we come back, we'll bisect and dissect some of those numbers for you. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow up 155, NASDAQ up 55, S&P's up 19. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow finished up 155, NASDAQ up 55, S&P's up 19. Let's go over to our man, Mr. John Logan, who kicks us off every trading day right here at TFNN, folks, 8 to 9 Eastern Standard Time in the morning. You want to understand what these markets have been doing. You want to understand where the markets are going. Check it out. Right on your cell phone, you can go to TFNN.com. You hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio. Now, as you're coming over to our website at TFNN, John is a great piece of software. It's a phenomenal piece of software. It's the TAS Profile Scanner. You can come test drive this absolutely free. There's a huge amount of videos that are on the site so that you can walk through exactly what you should be looking at on the scanner. And as you're looking, of course, you'll get to understand what it all means. And as of course, when you listen to John in the morning, he's going to be walking you through this each and every trading day. John Logan, what's going on?
Hey, buddy. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Good. Good. Good to be back with you.
Yeah, you guys have got hit by North Carolina with some weather there, man, you know, last couple weeks. I know it's nice now, but you got some weather, didn't you?
Yeah, it just got me sick, too. So I've been either traveling or under the weather, and I haven't been on your show in so long. I forgot what a treat it was.
You're too funny, man. Okay, so yeah, let's see. We get the market breath up here. That's what we're looking at, right? Is that what we're looking at?
Yeah, I just wanted to start with this because, cool. You know, we had, and the VIX has gone even lower than we were talking about recently, and that's amazing in itself. But we've been talking about the market doing a non-directional play, and we based that on really the metrics of what was going on, you know, with the individual stocks within the S&P index itself.
Yes.
And that really was showing just the most incredibly balanced situation ever I'd really ever seen on a continuous basis. So
really interesting.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah. Okay. We had so many, and that's why I was just, you know, okay, let's look at doing a non-directional play, because a couple of things were slanted towards the, you know, biased towards the long side because of that. Okay, let's ramp up and shelf off and instead of pulling back, and that usually is a continuation pattern, but you never know. And it was so hard to call, and you know, Trump could say anything and freak out, you know, half the world and
plenty of companies. Hey, yep. No,
oh
no.
God. I mean, you know, he could say, all right, well, a number of things and cause any sector to just crater or rally. Just like some of the stocks we talked about this morning in the kind of build the wall sector.
Yes.
So, you know, and he, you know, has that tendency of doing things kind of spur of the moment. So you never can really count on a market acting technically, I guess, in a normal way with that overhanging, you know, kind of situation on your hands. So it was really difficult also, you know, to look at the VIX where it was at and say, you know what, nobody seems to really care about, you know, what may come out of his mouth or what kind of new global event may happen. So, you know, you never, again, that kind of was a little bit of a contraindicator for the market to continue to go north. But the reason we looked at the non-directional trade, all things considered about what I just said, was, you know, these metrics within the scanner were basically saying, you know, we had about 250 some stocks, I think 260 stocks, that were trading within the so-called balanced area of the S&P on two or three different time frames. It was wild that these were lining up like this.
Yeah, that is wild, man.
Yeah, no, really. And I'd never seen that before. And we had no indications other than, you know, this thing was ultimately going to blow out one way or the other. And the VIX was where I was at. So you kind of had to look at buying volatility, of course, instead of selling volatility to try to do a non-directional trade. So, and I got to admit to you, this morning it busted out towards the upside, obviously, and I actually kind of unloaded one half of that strangle, that kind of non-directional buy volatility trade, just because I don't know if, Dow 20,000, the whole nine yards, this market's kind of got some fundamental things that are, I feel, are a little bit not in its greatest favor.
And that being said, just so the audience can understand that. So picture, folks, when you unload that. So he was delta neutral. You know, that means you have both positions. When he unloads it, though, what happens, folks, is that the option market doesn't open until the equity market opens. So, like, it's not that you're really underwater because you unloaded it at the open. So it's like we opened up almost here. Do you know what I mean? I just want to explain that kind of. Do you know what I mean? So,
right. No. Yeah. It's a good point, Tom, because also when you have that kind of gap up one way or the other, you have a lot of people adjusting positions in those options markets when that happens, especially on the open. And so the premiums actually get, to some degree, a little weird, usually in the seller's favor. So this was a non-directional trade. I dismantled some of it or on the upside, and I'm trying to, you know, look at it as you know, we may have a chance to retrace at least back to where we broke out from, and possibly even lower. So again, you know, the metrics right now are pretty strong. You know, the market is really kind of folded into an imbalanced state on the upside, and there's no real technical reasons blown above 20,000 to think that way. But, you know, at least that non-directional trade is almost turned into, to some degree, not a free trade yet on the downside if we pull back, but it, you know, it did something it was supposed to do. It broke out with a pretty big move on the upside.
Yes.
And that strangle, you know, did its thing for not totally.
You get your bread on that side. That's it. Exactly. Right. Now the question is, so when that happens, folks, okay, the bottom line is that would be the call part of the section. You know, it goes up, you grab your bread. Now the question is going to be, is that if it keeps going up, then you'll lose bread on the other side or you close it. But if it goes down, then you're going to get both sides of it. And you know it's going to be intriguing tonight, John. And I think you kind of like the dollar here. I mean, I'm on the other side of that. But this dollar...
You may be right about that, by the way.
Well, it's just, you know, what's just intriguing about this dollar is that, you know, it had light volume the last couple of days. So I'm saying to myself, we should do a bounce. I mean, you know.
Right.
And it's not bouncing. It's like, wow, this is interesting. And, you know, someone... you know, just hamming it down, another 200 ticks coming into the close. So it's like, okay, well, we're going to have an exciting night tonight, you know?
Yeah, I saw that.
And, you better get some sleep tonight.
How much of that do you think is, you know, Trump, you know, making these decisions like he does, and then the Republican, you know, in control of the Senate and the House, and then kind of like a lot of these decisions might be default passed into, you know, some kind of law? He wants that dollar to go down, right? I mean,
yeah, I think we're at the beginning of just a big fight between all these huge shocks. And the reason I'm saying that is that, to me, you know, the finance business and the political business are the biggest shocks in the world, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, yesterday you had, you know, the pipelines are going to open, and the Journal, I think, fired off the first volley today in their editorial. So the Journal, folks, the editorial today in the Journal was that, thank you, Trump, yes, that should be opened up because they couldn't stand Obama closing them down. But then they came right back and says, hey, you know what, you can't tell companies to turn around and use U.S. steel. So,
oh, I know.
You know, so my take on that, John, goes like this, and folks, is that what happens is that that's a protective stance. And I know there's plenty of folks that think, okay, want a protective stance. in the country. Well, that's not even capitalism. This is a dictatorship that, and companies aren't going to take that, man.
No, I agree. You know? That's going to ultimately hit the bottom line big time.
Yeah. Just stay with us. And it's all, I think it's going to, the journal kind of started it today, I think. Do you know what I mean?
This is going to be the shocker, you know, for the market to really get hold of that concept.
It's a battle. Stay right there. John and I are coming right back, folks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We're coming right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has put together the finest live programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 9 hours a day starting at 8 a.m. as John Logan kicks us off each trading day with the Global Market Pulse. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour, following the Tom O'Brien Show. Mondays and Fridays, catch live trading on the Nadex platform with hosts Tom and Tommy O'Brien, along with Gerald Martin on the Bull Bear Binary Option Hour. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN show and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking about our man, Mr. John Logan. We are talking markets. And, of course, don't forget, folks, every trading day right here, 8 o'clock in the morning, you can get John's program, outstanding program. If you want to understand, number one, what's going on in the marketplace across the world as well as the United States, bring John to work with you. Wake up with him, folks. Right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio. John walks through this scanner each and every day. And if you want the power right at your fingertips, folks, just come over to our website at TFNN and you can test drive this scanner absolutely free. It's right on the front page. You're going to see it right in the carousel. Just go down one on the carousel and it's right there. Profile scanner plus new videos available for free. Check it out. You know, bottom line is that we get a lot of action, no doubt. It's got up to the 20,000. You had the bulls and the bears fighting, you know, inside the scanner with the 250, 230, whatever that is. And the bulls won. You know, so I guess we see where it just shakes off now, right?
Yeah, I had to turn off the dim because we had a little echo in there. So I'm not showing my screen right now, Tom. You're still there, right?
Yeah, oh yeah, absolutely.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah, sorry about that. I think you guys might be having some problems with the dim. It was like a massive echo. I couldn't understand what you were saying.
Okay, cool. Okay.
I tell you what, we can talk about a couple of things. You know, finish up what we were talking about, though,
yes,
without even showing the screens. You know, just like you were alluding to, you know, with the dollar and, you know, who knows what's going to happen when some of these mandates start coming through. You know, it's not like you just get to fix everything, as you know. I'm sure you've been talking about this on the show, but, you know, you can't just tax things coming in if you don't play ball and make things here. It's almost like a net, you know, zero game. I mean, you make them here, they're going to cost you more. You make them over there, and then you tax them coming in, and people are just going to pay more, period.
Right. Well, we're going to pay more now, and it's, you know, and I had explained this. I got a couple calls in.
And then people, you know, buy less, you know what I mean?
So, no, and what had happened is that, you see, technically to me, the dollar failed anyway, okay, at 100.600. But fundamentally, if we have tariffs, the world needs less dollars. Our reserve currency of the world, folks, is not going to change. That's not going to change. I don't see a change. And I can go back to the 70s, 80s. No matter where I was, people always wanted dollars. What does change, though, is that, and you got to wrap your head around this concept, when you're trading all the time, the reason that everyone needs so many dollars is that they want to sell to the United States. They can't sell to the United States anymore. Guess what? You don't need those dollars. And we have plenty of dollars in the United States. If we're just going to buy stuff in the United States, well, guess what? You don't need as many dollars. It's a cut and dry deal. You know what I mean? It's like, okay, so, you know, we'll see where it shakes out. But
And you got to think, though, that with the market not showing any fear whatsoever of that out there, and the VIX being sub 11 today.
Right.
That is, you know, I mean, some people are going, you know, now everybody's jumping on the bandwagon. Oh, things are going to be so rosy that the VIX is probably going down to 8. But, you know, everybody thinks this is just going to be a free-for-all, like grab everything, you know, if you're involved with the market and stuff it in your pocket. Some of those things you just said, I mean, you don't get to have this like both ways. So
watch this. It's so right. And folks, so check this out. This is pretty wild. When I first started in the market, okay, which is 1981, I started in the bankrupt bond business. So I was absolutely ripping apart balance sheets, and, you know, that's a fundamentalist, right? I mean, because I was buying and selling bankrupt bonds, right? And I was a market, you know what I mean? It didn't matter, you know, I was making sure I would buy them. But that's a fundamental position. That's what you're doing. You're trying to figure out what's worth. So then, you know, like 9 years later, I said, man, you know, first off, I knew from doing that how much everyone lies in companies. So I was like, okay, man, this, you know, I start getting into technicals. I said, well, I can bisect and dissect a lot more technically, because the difference to me of technical analysis and fundamental analysis is fundamental analysis, folks, you believe in what the company says to you. Technical analysis, you believe in what the charts are saying to you. Listen, they both can be wrong, but I decided that I like the charts better. Because that's the supply and demand curve, right? That's the, you know, what the scan is all about. Okay, where's the money going in and out?
Right.
So now that we have the situation, whether it's TAFs or large companies, I'm saying to myself, like, oh, this is crazy, man, because in my own head, fundamentally, in common sense, I said, these companies have to make less money because, like, the companies that he had in Washington, D.C. the other day, folks, he's saying that there's going to be tariffs. Those are the companies that are going to get hurt before I'm belief because they make everything outside of the country. It's like, okay, well, you know, are they going to smile? So, hey, you know, it's like, when I just look at that, I say, and then I don't want to get too hung up on that either, John. Do you know what I mean? It's like, okay, don't get hung up on that now.
No. I hear what you're saying, but this, I almost think you have to, like, keep that in the back of your mind. That's why I can't understand, like, that's got to be in everybody's mind who's trading the markets right now. That blows me away that the VIX is as slow, because maybe it's not enough in their mind, and then, therefore, it's really, really time to buy volatility, you know,
Listen, I agree. Because when we started the conversation, I didn't know who was going to start the brawl.
Right.
But to me, the journal started it today. It's subtle, but they started it. Do you know what I mean? Because what happens, folks, is that when you have the biggest and strongest companies in the world, And now we got one of the most aggressive presidents in the world.
Yeah.
They're going to go at each other. And, you know, thus far, they've been bowing and kissing the ring and all of that. Well, when you're talking billions, you know, John knows as well as anyone that's in this business, when you work for one of these companies, folks, you can make them billions of dollars, and the next day they flush you down the toilet. So yeah. It's like, they're vicious, man. They're like, you know, so it's like, I was trying to figure out who's going to start this war, man. You know what I mean? So,
it's weird that, you know, you said the Wall Street Journal started this conversation, just hinted at it today. Nobody who's on the TV wants to even talk about it because it will freak people out if they really start digging into what, you know, the ramifications really are.
Right. Right.
And then, you know, but, you know, we need volatility, so I'm kind of waiting for them to start talking about it.
No, I agree. And what the journal actually brought up was actually more than just the aspect of doing it. They actually brought up that, hold it, that, what are we talking about here? You're talking about someone telling me, as a company in the United States of America, what I am going to do with my shareholders' money, period.
Yeah.
Well, that's a whole different ball game, man.
That's really what it boils down to. I mean, and you know, that's dismantling the free markets, which is kind of what Republicans more than anybody else stands for, which have created mostly all these, you know, free trade agreements, which, again, that's proven to be great for companies.
So you know what, folks? This is going to be an amazing learning adventure. You know, as you go through cycles in the marketplace, right, nothing's ever the same. And that's kind of the way I'm looking at it, John. Do you know what I mean? We're going to get a good learning adventure here. And the bulls and the bears are going to be fighting, man. And the bears lost today.
you got to think, though, too, like maybe a lot of, you know, maybe the talking heads are thinking, okay, well, he did actually put mostly, you know, market savvy individuals, to say the least, on his staff. And maybe they're going to kind of at some point get in a huddle with him and go, hey, buddy, you know, you can't really do all these things.
Oh, he can. So, you stay right there. Yeah. No one's going to tell him what to do.
Yeah,
you stay right there, folks. John and I are coming right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets.
Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with our man, Mr. John Logan, who kicks us off every trading day, folks. And if you come over to our website at TFNN, you're going to see right in the number two position of the carousel, TAS Profile Scanner Plus. New videos now available for free. Bottom line is that you can test drive this scanner. It's a fabulous tool, folks. Great piece of software. Get you around the marketplace and get you around the marketplace very, very quickly. So let's see. What are we looking at out here?
Yeah, I figured out how to turn down the volume in the den for that echo. So apologize for not having my charts up earlier, Tom.
No, that's cool.
You know, there's a couple of, I mean, in markets like today, you kind of really figure out quickly what's not cooperating.
Yes.
And there's some very clarifying events for some of these stocks and some of the stockholders of some of the stocks that just don't participate on days like today. And by the way, you remember that stock ENDP we've been talking about?
Yes.
Oh my God, have you looked at that thing lately? This has been one that's been showing itself pretty well. I'm going to pull this up in eSignal. This is a good example of being able to, you know, kind of find things that aren't, you know, things that are lower type
that's
things.
Sick.
So there are great shorting opportunities,
yep.
Even more so in markets like this, because you find things that just, man, are.
That's amazing.
You know, that people so are
this
leaving
equity that John's talking about, folks, straight down from $96 to $11, and that's from last April. And it has that high volume swing low. That's crazy, man.
Yeah, gave you a couple of good reasons to get back in on the short side recently. And,
yeah.
You know, so, but in the scanner, you know, there's a couple of things out there that I've kind of, I mean, Procter & Gamble's been a nice little trade from the short side, kind of coming into these weekly and for highs, especially today, and selling off. I think that thing could kind of come down and complete the cycle to the bottom of the profile again. But,
okay.
You know, gold is, you know, kind of come off of those weekly and for highs off 1211. Had a pretty good pullback today, but there's some stocks out there. Let's pull up Coca-Cola. That's a stock that's been in the scanner for a while.
Yeah.
And what it's done now is it's getting back into, let me pull up the daily here.
Okay.
It's getting back up into like a day like today, you know, you're always kind of looking for inflection points to play defense against if you're going to short something. So Coca-Cola basically today, it's been in a big downtrend. It finally got back up into an area where you could trade it from the short side. It's really bounced around and just kind of stayed within this fair auction recently the past, what, 2 or 3 months?
Yes.
Still in a defined downtrend as far as I'm concerned, but this is one that, you know, 42.40, you kind of got the market empathetically lifting it up, but I think right now, not making new highs and then being in the downtrend, Coca-Cola has given you a chance to get out of some longs if you tried to trade this bounce or if you're an investor. I think we're going to probably just sail back, you know, into the 40s and maybe even the 39s and 38s of the world on this.
Yeah, and with John's, you know, it's so cool, folks, as you go through the scanner, because you can see this has been a one-way move since November 4th, up. And Coca-Cola has been up all of 4 days. It's like, oh,
right.
Really? You know, yeah.
No,
that's a huge problem.
A couple of stocks. The scanner also defines some, you know, what's called breakdowns relative to profiles.
Yes.
You just click on these custom buttons on the left. You can set the screen up however you want
to. And look at that, auto zones right at the top.
Yeah. No, and some of these, you know, CA Incorporated, these are ones that just, man, I mean, really may have some more big downside moves. Day like today, people are exiting these particular stocks. Are you kidding me? break out above 20,000, these are the ones that you kind of put on your radar screen, because if we have any type of market comeback or even a market that sits still, these things have really got some chances, because it's
sure,
you know, to sell lower. I mean, because you know as well as I mean, you almost have to, you know, stocks that are breaking out today are just, a lot of them are just doing it to do it because we passed 20,000. I mean, some of these stocks that you find these anomalies going on, these are the ones you can, you know, almost increase the odds situations. Here's
it is. It
AutoZone.
Absolutely is.
I mean, this is really looking like it's on the edge of the cliff, not even wanting to bounce off of it today.
Right, right. And O'Reilly Automotive went down too yesterday. And this is a situation, as we were talking a little bit earlier, this situation here, folks. Now, they both have high volume swing lows, so to me, they want to go lower anyway. But fundamentally what happened is that if, in fact, there's a 35% tariff that's going to be coming in over Mexico, both of these companies take in over 60% of their product over that border. 60% of their product, John. 65, I think, O'Reilly. Isn't that sick?
That's crazy.
And so what happened yesterday, simultaneously, that came out, and then simultaneously, Amazon is saying that they're going to get in the business. But I think it's the tariff, because Amazon's been in the car business for a while. But they did make a couple good partnerships with the actual part makers. So, and that's a freaking horror show, right? You imagine competing with Amazon. Exactly.
I mean, people are probably trying to figure out how to get out of that trade still. I mean, big portfolio fund managers. I mean, I don't think it's even remotely unwound.
No, not for. And it's not, let me just go. I just want to see this quickly, because what happens on some of these big stocks like this, like, O'Reilly, these are all institutions that own them, all the top ones, big institutions, man. Yeah, you're talking, you know, T. Rowe Price is the largest owner, that's 10%. Then you get Vanguard, 6%, BlackRock, 5%, Fidelity, 4.9%, State Street, 4.1%. Yeah, it's all institutions, right?
You know what's sad for them, too? If they're like, oh, my God, we can't unwind it because we're going to kill ourselves. It's going to be a self-fulfilling prophecy. We're just going to start getting lower prints because we're the ones driving it down.
Isn't that heavy?
Yeah. Yeah, but the other side of the coin is they go into the options market and start, you know, buying puts, then the options market maker is going to have to take the other side of that trade. And the only way he's going to do it is if he hedges against the stock.
And they know it right away, man.
So there's no way out.
Right.
You know?
Right.
I mean, there's...
So this
crazy
screen here that we're looking at, tell me what screen this is now. This is Amazon at the top?
Yeah, this is... Yeah, well, this one's called Downtrend Resistance.
Okay.
Amazon's probably one of the more scarier stocks to trade from the short side. But, you know, Amazon didn't make new highs today. It's kind of gotten up into an area on our weekly chart. These are kind of recent highs. So this one's probably not the most attractive. I think we probably should leave this alone.
I'm just curious. No, because it's like, you know, they're coming out with their earnings in a second. It's like, okay, this, you know, you're right next to a high. It's like 847. It's not going to go to 836 without probably hitting that high, right?
One that's kind of, one way or the other here, Foot Locker. I'm not a big fan of any, you know, type brick and mortar. I mean, there's so many people that are ordering stuff online. But Foot Locker broke below these week. It kind of technically had a good break here, and it's kind of rallying back up into these unfair lows at 69.60, and that could pop. You got a good place to play defense here, but I don't think this kind of sell off and then consolidation. I think the technical scene is broken here, and we may actually see some more downside on Foot Locker.
And folks, you can test drive the scanner right here, right now. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right in the carousel. Hit it, test drive it absolutely free. And of course, listen to John tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Outstanding show. John, thanks so much. Great having you back, man. Can't wait for the show tomorrow.
See you.
Have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. We've got a bunch of numbers coming out for you in the next 10 minutes.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, if you'd like to come to my webinar tomorrow night, I'm doing a free webinar. It's on the Nugget and Dust. It's on leveraged ETFs. It's from 6 to 7 Eastern Standard Time tomorrow night. It's free. Just we need your name and your email. Check it out on the front page of TFNN. Qualcomm, let's go through some numbers here. So Qualcomm come out with numbers. Qualcomm closed at $56.90. That's trading at $55.48. And let's see what they have to say. So Qualcomm, the revenue estimate was $6.11 billion. They came in with $5.99 billion. So slightly lower. Bottom line is that for Qualcomm's case, that's going to be a real problem, because that already gapped down from 65 to 53. Bottom line is that now you're down a couple bucks right now. eBay, we take a look at eBay. eBay closed out the day today at $30.23. That's trading up $2.50 at $32.72. Let's see what eBay has to say. eBay, the earnings estimate was 53 cents. They made 54. Their revenue, the estimate was $2.4 billion. They made $2.4 billion. We get to look Mattel. Mattel is getting toasted out here after the close. Mattel, the toy company, that closed at $31.56. That's trading at $28.26. And let's see what Mattel's happening. What's happening, Mattel? So Mattel out here, their earnings were 52 cents. The estimate sales was $1.96 billion. They only took in $1.83 billion. Their Fisher Price worldwide Sales were $607 million. That's down 3%. They get bottom line is that not that, that is certainly not a brick and mortar company. But what does happen, of course, is that the amount of toy stores that has gone out of business is pretty dramatic. There's the in a big way, which makes a difference. Las Vegas Sands. Las Vegas Sands closed at $56.65. That's trading down $3. That's at $53.90. Let's see what how much gambling we're getting done in Las Vegas and in China. So the revenue estimate was $3.12 billion. They came in at $3 billion. Earnings per share, the estimate was 66 cents. They made 62. So bottom line, they missed on the top line and the bottom line. This also does have a high volume swing low at 54. So it's going to blow through that 54. Let's see, where are we at right now? We are at 53.90. And if you want to see how things like testing high volume swings, this is one of them. We bring this back a bit. Yeah, this wants to make its way down to 41, 36, somewhere in there. So it's a big number. Let me just go look. I don't think Wynn was coming out with numbers. Wynn was coming out with numbers. Okay, so Wynn closed at $96.42. That's trading at $95.73. Let's see what they have to say. Oh, actually, so what's going on here is that, see, Wynn hasn't come out yet. So Wynn is trading down on the Las Vegas Sands numbers. That would make sense, too, folks, because both Wynn and Las Vegas Sands, they have some of the biggest casinos in Las Vegas. They have some of the biggest casinos in Macau, China also. So bottom line, we'll see where that WYNN, where that baby looks like it wants to go. So 96, this has been quite a downtrend too. This is off a high of 247. This has a high volume swing low of $50. Holy cow. The top of that high volume low is 77.25. It looks to me like you get some game coming up to that point. Now, overnight, folks, check it out. Overnight, you can expect big action in the dollar tonight. This dollar, they're hammering this dollar lower. You're down 439 ticks right now. We're at 99,900. I expect we're going to see a 98 print overnight. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock, John Logan. Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.